The numerical relationships between chemical amounts in a balanced chemical equation are called reaction stoichiometry. Stoichiometry allows us to predict the amounts of products that will form in a chemical reaction based on the amounts of reactants that react. Determine the amount of reactants necessary to form a given amount of products. Stoichiometry operations include mole to mole, moles to grams, and vice versa.
So for the chemical equation, Fe2O3 plus 2Al to Al2O3 plus 2Fe, well, when you take 1.24 moles of Al reacting with Al2O3, how many moles are produced? So you'll have to take 1.247 moles of Al times 1 mole of Al 2O3 over 2 moles of Al, which equals 0.6235 moles of Al.
So using the equation above, we're going to figure out how many grams of Fe2O3 are required to produce 4.32 moles of Fe. You start off with 4.32 moles of Fe and multiply it by 1 mole of Fe2O3 divided by 2 moles of Fe and multiply the molar mass of Fe2O3, which is 159.7 grams Fe2O3. Then you divide by 1 mole of Fe2O3, which equals 344.9 grams of Fe2O3, and with sig figs it equals 345 grams of Fe2O3.
Diborane, which is B2H6, was considered to be used as rocket fuel during 1947 through 1949. It was shown that using diborane would have many disadvantages. But let's say it was used for rocket fuel.
Using the chemical equation B2H6 plus 3O2, to B2O3 plus 3H2O.
How many grams of O2 would be required to burn 17 moles of B2H6 completely? To figure this out, you would need to take 17 moles of B2H6 multiplied by the ratio of 3 moles of O2 divided by 1 mole of B2H6. Then you multiply the molar mass of O2, which is 32 grams, and divide that by 1 mole of O2. That gives us 1,632 grams of O2. So it would take 1,632 grams of O2 to burn 17 moles of B2H6 completely.